गुड आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम
मॉर्निंग सेशन वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फाइंडिंग द इक्वेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रेट लाइन फाइंडिंग इक्वेशंस ऑफ स्ट्रेट लाइन एंड डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स आर गिवन ओके सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद दैट राइट डाउन राइट द क्वेश्चन फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ द लाइन फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ द लाइन पासिंग थ्रू Find the equation of the line passing through 1, 2. Find the equation of the line passing through 1, 2, and making an angle of 30 degrees with y-axis. The question is. Find the equation of the line passing through the point. Okay, so the line passes through 1, 2. It passes through the point 1, 2. Okay, now this is okay. If you draw the point, okay, 1, 2, x-axis 1. So suppose this is a point. So line is passing like this, and it makes an angle 30 degrees with y-axis. So what will be the angle made with the x-axis? What will be the angle made by the line with the x-axis?
60.
It will be 60. Okay. So here we can take the angle theta is equal to 60 degrees. You have to find the equation of the line. So angle is given. From here you can find out what is m. M is equal to. Tan theta, which is equal to tan 60. Tan 60 it is root 3, isn't it? So here we got this.
Root 3.
And the point is given. One point and slope is given. So it will be the equation of the line. If one point and slope is given means equation of the line is Aditya Satyan, can you give the equation of the line? One point slope form.
Y minus y dash is equal to m minus x is equal to x dash
or x naught, whatever. Okay. Y minus y naught is equal to m into x minus x naught. So y minus, to take the point as y. 2 is equal to root 3 into x minus 1. So I'm simplifying and writing the general form. Write the equation in general form. The equation, okay, general form is always like this. Ax plus by plus c is 0. Linear equation represents a straight line. Over. Is it okay? Next one. Next question, children. So, what is the answer? What is the general form? When you write in general form, what is the equation you are getting here? When you open the bracket and simplify, what you will get? Root 3x plus y. If you take it to other side, it is minus y minus root 3 plus 2 is 0. Are you getting in this form, Achyut? Are you getting this form, Achyut?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Nandana, is it okay, Nandana?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now write the next question. Find the equation of the line. Find the equation of the line whose y-intercept is minus 3. Find the equation of the line whose y-intercept is minus 3. and which is first case, it is parallel to parallel to line joining the points -2, 3 and 4, -5. Second one, perpendicular to line joining the points 0, -5. And -1, 3. Okay. Find the equation of the line, straight line, whose y-intercept is -3. So y-intercept is -3. Give the points. Okay, children. See, look at the question. Read the question. Find the equation of the straight line whose y-intercept is -3. Y-intercept is given and which is parallel to the line joining. Okay, now consider the first case. Okay, we are going to find out the equation of the line parallel to line joining these two. Y-intercept is -3. So can you give the point? What will be the point here? The line is, y-intercept is -3 means it cuts y-axis, isn't it? Y-axis at -3. So can you give the point? Or you can denote this as y-intercept is. Okay, the same question we can do it in two ways too. Y-intercept means you can take the point as 0, -3. Is it correct? On y-axis, x-coordinate is it 0? And what is given? Two points are given. Can you find out the slope of the line? What will be the slope of the line? So suppose I take this first point as A and this point as B. What will be slope of AB? Two points are given. So slope of AB will be y2 - y1 / x2 - x1. Slope is change in y by change in x. So -5 - 3/4 - -2. So it is -8/6. Is it correct? y2 - y1. So slope we can take it as m = -4/3. So we can solve this question by using point slope form. Or you can take y-intercept, we can denote this as yc = -3. Or you can take the other form. Two forms are there. y - y0 = m · x - x0. If you are taking the point and slope means you can do it in this way. Or we can take y = mx + c. Both are applicable here. Because y-intercept is given. From there you can find the point and you can substitute. Is it clear? It is given as parallel. Okay. So slope of the line will be same as slope of this line joining. So that's what we are taking. m = -4/3. Okay. AB is parallel to the line. So slopes will be equal. So slope of the line will be same as slope of AB. That's what we are taking. So m = -4/3. Aditya, are you able to understand this one? Is it okay, Aditya? Sanya? Aditya, is it clear? Aditya, Satyam?
Yes, ma'am.
It is given y intercept, so you are taking the point. The first case, what is given? It is parallel to the line. So parallel means slopes will be equal. So we are finding the slope of AB, that will be same as slope of the line. And then what will be the equation? On completing it, what is the answer? What will be the equation of the line?
Ma'am.
Yes, Achyut.
Can you substitute and show?
So y minus, which method you followed, with the first one or second one?
Second one.
Y is equal to mx plus c. So y is equal to minus 4 by 3x plus minus 3. Is it okay? Y is equal to mx plus c. So in the place of m, slope is minus 4 by 3. C is 3. So when you cross multiply, 3y is equal to negative 4x minus 9. Okay, multiply throughout by 3. And when you rearrange it, 4x plus 3y plus 9 is equal to 0. Is it okay, Aparna? Is it this answer you are getting? Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Achyut, is it okay, Achyut?
Yes, ma'am.
Aryan, is it clear? Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes.
In the first, y minus y zero, in that, what will we give as y zero?
That point you can take, this is x naught, y naught.
That c is zero comma minus 3.
Yes, yes. You take that as a point.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. If you're trying that way, are you getting the answer? Check it. Y minus y naught. Y plus 3 is minus 4 into x minus 0. So when you cross multiply, 3y plus 9 is equal to negative 4x. Okay. So here also you'll get the same equation. 4x plus 3y plus 9 is equal to 0. Both the methods are right. Either you can, which method you feel easy, that way you can do. This question, we have two methods. Is it okay, Michael? Michael, is it clear? Is it okay? Which method do you use here?
Yes, ma'am.
Which one you use? First one or second one? Point slope form or intercept form? Slope intercept form. Which one you used here for solving? Which one? Which method did you use, Michael? How do you solve both the method? Used. Okay, here either we can solve it by using point slope form or we can use slope intercept form. Both the methods are allowed. Okay, now look at the second part. In second part, what is given? It says Roman letter 2, find the equation of the line whose y intercept is minus 3. So y intercept means, if suppose I want to do it in the second method, means y intercept, it is minus 3. And it is given, the line is perpendicular to, line joining the points 0, negative 5 and minus 1, 3. Okay, it is perpendicular. If two lines are perpendicular, what will be the what do you know about the slopes?
Product of the slope is.
The slope is minus 1, isn't
minus
it?
Minus 1.
Okay. So from here, you find the slope of the line. So it will be the slope here. Y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So y2 minus y1 means you get 3 minus of minus 5 by minus 1 minus 0. So you get 8 by minus 1. Is it minus 8? So this is slope of the line. So what will be the slope of the perpendicular line? What is m2? M1 into M2 is minus 1. So what is M2? minus 1 by m1. Product of the slope is minus 1. So what will be the slope of the second line? Slope of the second line is the reciprocal of the first one, and you have to change the sign. Minus of 1 by m. So here the slope of the line is minus 8. So it will be the slope of the perpendicular line, minus 1 by minus 8. So which is 1 by 8. So we are taking slope as 1 by 8. Already the intercept is given. Is it okay, Tomlin? How we are getting this perpendicular line slope? Is it clear? Okay, listen children. Suppose, listen, look, answer to this question. Suppose slope of a line is 5. What will be the slope of the parallel line? What will be the slope of the parallel line? Krishna Chandran, what is the answer? Slope of a line is 5. What will be the slope of the parallel line?
5.
5. Because 5. Two lines are parallel means slopes are equal. Good. Okay. What will be the slope of the perpendicular line? Dia. What will be the slope of the perpendicular line? Slope of a line is 5. What will be the slope of the perpendicular? Yes, Dia. Dia. Okay, Nandana.
Minus 1 by 5.
Minus 1 by 5. If a slope of a line is 5, the perpendicular line slope will be negative 1 by 5. Take the reciprocal and change the sign. Okay? So, that's what we did. Suppose we take this as m1 and this is m2. What is m1 into m2? What is m1 into m2? 5 into minus 1 by 5. They will be getting 1. So, if a slope of a line is m, the perpendicular line slope will be minus 1 by m. Okay, now here, slope of this line is minus, and the equation we want. Is it is perpendicular to this line, so it is 1 by 8. So now find the equation of the line. Find out the equation of the line. Slope is given, intercept is known. What is the equation of the line? Srihari, give the equation of the line. Do it and give the answer. Y is equal to mx plus c. That form only you are using. Dia, can you give the answer now? Dia, m is given and c is given. What is the equation of the line? Yes, Dia, what is the answer? M and C, you substitute it and tell me. Gayatri, what is the answer you got here? What is the equation of the line? Gayatri.
I'm doing.
Doing. Sanya, what is the answer, Sanya?
X minus 8y minus 24 is equal to 0.
X minus 8y minus 24 is 0. Write the next one. Next model is very important. Write the next one. Find the equation of the right bisector. Find the equation of the right bisector of the line segment. Find the equation of the right bisector of the line segment joining the points 3, 4. And minus 1, 2. Find the equation of right bisector of the line segment joining the points 3, 4 and minus 1, 2. Find the equation of right bisector of the line segment joining 3, 4 and negative 1, 2. What is meant by right bisector? You are asked to find the right bisector of the line segment joining these two points. So how you do this? Right bisector, how we have to find it? Yes? Right bisector means which are the two conditions to be satisfied. From the word itself we can want to find the equation of the line. It is the right bisector. That means?
Perpendicular lines.
Very good. It should be perpendicular. Then? One more word is there. Okay. Right bisector. Yes? Gauri?
90 degree.
And that's what she meant from perpendicular. Then?
Midpoint.
Okay, that means it is the perpendicular bisector. Right bisector means what does it mean? We want to find the perpendicular bisector of line joining these two points. Okay, the question is, okay, suppose these are the two points. Okay, just mark it, 3, 4. And minus 1, 2. We want to find the perpendicular bisector. That means we should find the midpoint. Suppose this is A, this is B. We want to find the midpoint of AB and a line perpendicular to it. So this equation we want to find. We want to find the equation of the perpendicular bisector. Is it okay? So write down. First, name the points. Let A 3, 4 and B minus 1, 2 be the given points. Let PQ be the perpendicular bisector of AB. Let PQ be the perpendicular bisector of AB. Okay, draw the figure. Then only you will be able to understand. Let PQ be the perpendicular bisector of AB. Okay, so first you find midpoint of AB. So it will be midpoint of AB. What's midpoint formula? Midpoint form is AB is Q of midpoint form.
X1 plus X2 by 2.
X1 plus X2 by 2, Y1 plus Y2 by 2. Add the x coordinates, divide by 2. Add the y coordinates and divide by 2. So it is 3 minus 1. 2 by 2 means it is 1. And the next one is 3. So point Q we got as 1, 3. So point Q is 1, 3. Now we want the slope of PQ. What can you say about slope of PQ? PQ is perpendicular to AB.
On y-axis.
That one I can't say it is on y-axis and all. Okay, just I drew a line. Okay, that's all. It is not x-axis, y-axis and all. Just for rough diagram only draw here. It's not by along the
product of slopes is minus one.
Product of the slopes is minus one. PQ is perpendicular to AB. So first we have to find the slope of AB. If you take this to find out the slope of AB, from here we can find out what will be the slope of PQ. So next you find what is slope of AB. What will be the slope of AB? Again you have to use the 2 points form. Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. When 2 points are given, slopes are given by Y2 minus Y1 by X minus X1. So 2 minus 4, which is minus 2 by minus 1 minus 3. So which is minus 2 by minus 4, which is 1 by 2. So what will be slope of PQ? What will be slope of PQ? Slope of AB is 1 by 2. So what will be the slope of PQ? PQ is perpendicular to AB, isn't it?
Minus 2.
This minus 2. Now we have one point we got, slope we got. So now can you give the equation of PQ? Okay, the point is there, point Q is 1 comma 3, slope is there. So what will be the equation of PQ? Equation of PQ is one point form we can use, isn't it? One point slope form. Y minus Y naught is equal to M into X minus X naught. Point is given, slope is given. Apply that one and simplify. What is the answer, Atul? Atul, can you give the answer, Atul?
2x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0.
2x plus y minus 5 is 0. Yes, correct answer, Atul. 2x plus y minus 5 is 0. Point is given and slope is also given. Just substitute it. Achyut, are you getting this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
What about Diya? Diya. Emmanuel, Tomlin, and I'll switch on your video. Emmanuel. Annette, Gayatri, write the next one, the perpendicular from the origin. The perpendicular from the origin meets the line. The perpendicular from the origin meets the line y is equal to mx plus c at minus 1 comma 2. Find the values of M and C. Find the values of M and C. present children. Okay, I'm marking the axis here. Suppose x-axis, y-axis is marked. What is given here? The perpendicular from the origin to the line y is equal to mx plus c. Okay, the perpendicular from the origin meets this line at minus 1 comma 2. So x-axis minus 1 and y 2 means somewhere here. Okay, suppose this is. Okay, this line passes, meets it. The perpendicular from the origin. So this is the perpendicular drawn from the origin. Origin means it is 0, 0. It meets the line y is equal to mx plus c at minus 1 comma 2. So the perpendicular drawn from the origin meets the line at minus 1 comma 2. Find the values of m and c. Can you give the values of m and c? How will you find?
Normal form.
Normal form. Here we are not asked to find the equation, isn't it? Normal form means we need one more angle is needed. Normal form, what is the form? X cos omega plus y sin omega. We need the angle. Your angle is not given. Then, any other next? Okay, think it. Okay, normal form, okay, but think it. The next one. Here we want to find what is m and what is c. We want to find the slope of the line and c.
We can find the slope of PO.
Okay, good. Yes.
It will be perpendicular, so product will be minus 1.
Yes, very good. Punya. Okay. We can find the slope of OP. Is that not? Origin is given. We know origin is 0, 0, although it is not given. Perpendicular drawn from the origin. So one point is 0, 0. And to the line, the point where it meets the line is given. So we can find the slope of OP. And OP is perpendicular to the line. So from there, okay, using the relation M1, M2 is equal to minus 1, we can find the slope of the line. M will be calculated. Okay. So that's the form we are going to use. Okay. So what is slope of OP? Slope of OP is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So 0 minus 2 by 0 minus of minus 1. So it is minus 2 by 1, which is minus 2. So, okay, now the line L. So L is perpendicular to OP. Therefore, what will be the slope of the line L? Slope of OP is minus 2. So it will be the slope of the perpendicular line. Okay, slope of a line is minus 2. What will be the slope of the perpendicular line? Navreen?
1 by 2.
Yes. Navreen, is it 1 by 2?
Yes.
Perpendicular line means take the reciprocal and change the sign. Okay, here slope is minus 2. So if you take the reciprocal, it is 1 by 2 and put the opposite sign. So m is 1 by 2. So we got the value of m. Now how to find c? Now look at the point minus 1 comma 2. Is it lying on the line? The point minus 1 comma 2 lies on the line y is equal to mx plus c. Isn't it? Is it a point on this line? So therefore x is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to 2 will satisfy this equation. So when you substitute here, you will get 2 is equal to minus m plus c. Is it correct? Point minus 1 comma 2 lies on a line. That means when you substitute x is minus 1 and y is equal to 2, it will satisfy that equation. So when you substitute it, y in the place of y, you can put 2. 2 is equal to mx, m into minus 1 plus c. Already we have calculated m. So 2 is equal to minus half plus c. From here, can you find and give me what is c? What is the value of c? is the value of C. Minus half, if we take to other side, it is 2 plus half. So what is the value of C? Aryan. What is 2 plus half? Aryan.
Five by two.
Aditya Satyan, is it the answer you are getting here?
Yes, ma'am.
Children, do these questions again. Okay, Aditya. Okay, do these questions once again, Nikita. Okay, it's similar questions only. You are going to discuss it using section formula and all. You are going to introduce it. So make it go through the same questions again. Learn the formulas and be thorough with the formula. Annette, in the next class I'll be asking the formulas. Be ready. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.